study circular queue implementation in data structure. Circular queue is implemented to overcome the advantage of a simple queue, where even though the spaces are empty in the array, we cannot add elements as rare has reached the size of the array. For the videos of queue, you can refer to the video queue of the same channel, Anuradha Bhatia. Now let's see how the circular queue works. Circular queue is a linear data structure. In circular queue, the last node is connected back to the first node to make a circle, as the name suggests. Circular queue follows the first in first out principle as a regular or a simple queue. Elements are added at the rear end and elements are deleted at the front of the queue. Both the front and the rear pointers point to the beginning of the array. It is also called as a ring buffer. Items are inserted and deleted from a queue in big O one time. That is the space complexity of my circular queue. Now this is a representation of a circular queue. If my front is here and my rear is here, both of them are connected in a circular fashion. This queue simply can sometimes also be represented as this notation, but it becomes difficult for us to understand how it works. So I've represented it in a normal array. So this is how a circular queue is usually represented as. Now, using arrays, circular queue can be implemented using arrays as well as using linked list. But we will see the implementation of a circular queue using linked list after we finish the studying what is the basics of linked list. So at present, we'll be implementing circular queue using arrays. In arrays, the range of the subscript is 0 to n minus 1, where n is the maximum size of my array. To make an array as a circular array by making the subscript 0 as the next address of the subscript n minus 1, by using the normal formula, subscript is equal to subscript plus 1 mod maximum size. So this is a formula which will be used to find out the address. In circular queue, the front and the rear pointers are updated by using the above formula. The function below explains to add an element into the circular queue using the arrays. We'll see the following slides which will tell us how the elements are added and removed from a circular queue. Now, to add an element in a circular queue using arrays, we say start. This is just an algorithm about it. We'll see the program which follows later. If front is equal to rear plus 1 mod max, print error circular queue overflow. Else, rear is equal to rear plus 1 mod max. Queue rear is equal to element, and if front is equal to minus 1, then f is initialized to 0, and then we stop. This is a small algorithm to add an element into a circular queue. Now, to delete an element from a circular queue using arrays, we say start. If front is equal to rear and rear is equal to minus 1, we say circular queue underflow. When we need to delete an element, then it is an underflow situation. When we add an element, it is an overflow situation. So element is equal to queue of front. If front is equal to rear, front is equal to rear is equal to minus 1. Else, front is equal to front plus 1 mod max and stop. This is how we work for deleting an element from a circular queue. Now write a program to insert, delete and display the elements of a circular queue. This is a complete menu-driven program which will be used to insert, delete and display the elements. This is a simple program which says insert is a function to insert, delete to delete the element and display to display the complete circular queue. Rear is minus 1, front is minus 1 for initial condition. Print 1 to insert, 2 to delete, 3 to display and 4 to exit. Enter your choice. So do it continues to work till you loop out and you do not wish to continue. Switch choice. Case 1 is insert, case 2 is delete, case 3 is display, case 4 is exit 0. And if you enter anything other than these 4, it says invalid choice. Please try again while 1. So till the answer is 1, we continue. Get CH. Now void insert. If front is equal to 0 and rear is equal to size minus 1, that is rear has not reached the maximum size, or front is equal to rear plus 1, that is if front is equal to rear plus 1. Now what is front is equal to rear plus 1? this is the situation and this is my circular queue. So what happens is, front is equal to rear plus 1. If this is the situation, my rear is here and my front is here. This is my rear and this is my front. If front is equal to rear plus 1, so if front is here, this means my queue is full. But if my front was at this position, then my queue was empty. Then I say else, enter the item. So we enter the item. If rear is minus 1, then rear is 0, front is 0. Else if rear is equal to size minus 1, rear is equal to 0, else rear plus plus, and we say queue of rear is equal to item. After we incremented the rear, we add the element and we sprint. Item is inserted. This is a simple delete. If front is equal to minus 1, we say queue is empty. Else, item is equal to queue front. So this is item is out, popped out. If front is equal to rear, front minus 1, rear minus 1. Else if front is equal to size minus 1. So these are all the checking condition. After they're all checked, item, it says item is deleted and printed over here. This is simple to display all the elements. If front is equal to minus 1 and front is equal to rear plus 1, queue is empty. Else print front I less than equal to rear I plus plus, and we print all the elements of the queue. Thank you. This is an implementation of circular queue using array.